We continue our program with panels about the clinics where Liv Hospital is the strongest and their innovations with the participation of our very valuable doctors. I invite the General Manager of Liv Hospital Ulus, Taner Özbek, to the stage, who will moderate the first panel on groundbreaking target-oriented treatments. Mr. Özbek, the stage is yours.
Sesim geliyor mu? Herkes duyabiliyor mu?
Yes. Hello to everyone. My name is Taner Özbek. When I first met with Bobby in Liv Hospital Ulus, he was like a dreamer of something like Liv Hospital Group, Liv Hospital chain like McDonald's. I found him a little bit dreamer, and then I feel like some action, and I think that I should met him with the actioner Mary Strate. So after this collision, our international department thanks them and all of the colleagues who consume effort for this evening and this show. Thank you all of them, and thank you all the audience who comes all around the world here today. I'm very honored to moderate the first panel with the doctors. And our panel subject is groundbreaking target-oriented treatments. Target-oriented is a concept, but a really special concept for the future of health. Individual treatments, target-oriented treatments, these are the terms probably will sign the future of the healthcare. And target-oriented, even though target-oriented is a general term, it reminds me like something physical about a tumor, like shape of it, maybe margin of it, type of it, maybe the distinction from the peripheral tissue. So I don't know why I feel like this. Am I right or not? So please, let's see and introduce my colleagues or professor for these answers. First of all, I'd like to introduce Professor Ferah Hece. She is the Chief Clinician of Pulmonary Department of Liv Hospital. First presentation will be hers, and then the second one, Professor İlhan Elmacı, the Chief Clinician of Brain Surgery, Neurosurgery. And the third panelist is the Professor Emel Ceylan. She is the Chief Clinician of the Nuclear Medicine. And the last one, Professor Emre Merdan Fayda. He is the clinician, Chief Clinician of Radiotherapy Department. So I don't want to waste time, so I leave the words for the first presenter, Professor Ferah.
Dear guests, welcome to Istanbul. My name is Ferah Ece. I'm a professor in pulmonology. I graduated from Marmara University Medical School, and then after I completed my pulmonary residency, I went to US, University of Texas MD Anderson Cancer Center. I worked there as a postdoctoral fellow and studied gene therapy in lung cancer. And also I attended to the divisions of interventional bronchology and sleep disorders as well. In 2009, I became a fellow of American Clinical Chest Physicians. Right now I'm working, I've been I've been working in Liv Hospital since its establishment as a medical doctor. And since 2018, I am the head of a medical executive committee. As a pulmonary department, as Liv Hospital, our main target is to raise the standards of medical care in Turkey. And we provide quality-oriented services, and we are doing this by combining cutting-edge technology assets and innovations together with collective knowledge and expertise, because the needs of the patient come first for us. Pulmonology at Liv Hospital is dedicated to understanding, diagnosing, and treating all types of lung diseases, like lung cancer, COPD, which is chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, asthma, pulmonary embolism, restrictive lung diseases, infectious lung diseases, sarcoidosis, bronchiectasis, and sleep apnea. We have comprehensive diagnostic and therapeutic capabilities. We offer a number of special tests and procedures. For example, in bronchoscopy suite, we use bronchoscopy for diagnostic and therapeutic options. And also in our pulmonary function laboratory, we do pulmonary function tests, diffusion capacity, and 6-minute walking test. We have facility like polysomnography in sleep lab, so we can diagnose obstructive sleep apnea, and also we are able to do CPAP titration test. In allergy clinic, in addition to skin prick tests, we are able to do molecular allergy test, which is a new technique. It shows us many types of allergens and also cross-reactivity between allergens as well. In our department, we are all oriented to different fields. For example, can I use pointer? Which one is pointer? This one? Okay, so I couldn't find the pointer. Myself is interested in lung cancer. My other colleague, Dr. Recep Dodurgalı, is interested in allergic diseases. And the other colleague, Dr. Mehmet Aydoğan, is interested in interstitial lung diseases. We provide world-class patient care to our patients together with combining our strengths in clinical care. If I'd like to give some examples, for instance, in lung cancer, we use bronchoscopy and EBUS, which is endobronchial ultrasonography, for diagnosis. Here you can see some bronchial tree regions, and here you see lung cancer obstructing main stem, right main stem bronchus. So we diagnose this disease by using bronchoscopy. In staging, we use EBUS, endobronchial ultrasonography, which is a less invasive technique. And there is an ultrasound probe at the tip of the bronchoscope. So we first localize the lesion, lymphadenopathy. Then we insert the needle inside it and take the specimen out. For treatment, we use interventional bronchoscopy, like first electrocoagulation, some lung cancer patients, argon plasma coagulation. Here you can see the argon plasma coagulation of the tumor tissue located in the main stem bronchus. And also we deploy stents. Like here, in trachea, there's a tumor lesion. After coagulation of the tumor lesion, we deploy stent in order to achieve airway patency. Another example is COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, which is a very common disease. There are two components, chronic bronchitis components and emphysema components in these patients. So in chronic bronchitis component oriented patients, in addition to standard medical treatment, we recommend respiratory rehabilitation, which is very important. And also nowadays, we use bronchoscopic mucoclearance, which is a very new technique. And I'd like to give a brief information about this technique. There is a balloon there and electrical pump. Together with the aid of this electrical pump, this balloon is inflating and deflating regularly, periodically. So here you can see, you can take the all mucus out from the bronchus and submucosal glands. So we aspirate all the stuff, all these aspirations, these secretions, then clear all the airways. We are doing this each by each, every segment, every lobe, every bronchus. So it's very elongated procedure, but it's very effective. After the procedure, patients feel very healthy and oxygen saturation is getting higher and higher. Also in emphysematous component patients, we deploy endobronchial valve or coil. This is an endobronchial valve. It works as check valve mechanism. And here you can deploy it into several bronchi, and it gives very relief for his breath, the patient's breath. Also, there is a coil. In the diffuse emphysematous patients, we use these coils. Of course, stem cell therapy, which is very important in our treatment strategy, because stem cell therapy can be used in very diffuse emphysematous patients and also in the end stage of lung. As you listened previously, we are so lucky because we have very well equipped stem cell laboratory, and after the approval from the Turkish Ministry of Health, we can use this therapy into selected patients. Okay, as a pulmonary department, together with our internal medicine departments, we provide an integrative, multidisciplinary approach to our patients. So, as a conclusion, they receive comprehensive and individualized patient care. This is also applicable to surgical brands as well. So now I would like to give the word to Professor Elmacı in order to summarize it in terms of surgical brands. Thank you.
Thank you for your presentation. And I have a question, if you're okay. We all know that doctors feel a little bit comfortable and their mind should be clear when they perform some difficult procedures. What makes you comfortable when you perform an intervention in Liv Hospital? It is important about like other supporter departments or infrastructure of the hospital. What's it?
In order to give a high quality health care, the doctor must feel safe. And in order to give this high quality care, you have to have well equipped high technology departments and also a good educated team. Because success comes from teamwork. Therefore, you feel safe when, for example, when I do interventional bronchoscopy in the operating room, I know that the anesthesiologists are expert in their field. And also, if there will be a complication, I know that I can call immediately my thoracic surgeon colleague, so he can come and help me on that case. Therefore, it's very important to these all facilities in one hospital. In Liv Hospital, I feel safe.
Wow, thank you. By the way, the audience, if you have any question for dear Professor Ferah Ece, your turn. Do you have any question? Okay, then we continue with the second presentation of Professor İlhan Elmacı. The stage is yours.
Thank you, Taner. Hi, everyone. I would like to say welcome again for Expo and to come to Istanbul. My location is Ulus Hospital, as you see that. And Ulus district area is very close to Bosphorus. This picture is coming from the early time of the day. As you see that very wonderful pictures and bridges on the right side. This side is European side, other side is Anatolian side. Firstly, I would like to mention about the expo, and after that, I would like to inform you about our advanced technology and experience. In my idea, there are some partners of the health service. The basic idea is about the patient. Patient needs the best treatment and satisfaction. And all of others is about these ideas. Physician, healthcare professionals, healthcare companies, and others. The end of the story will be happiness will be there or must be there, I think that. What is the advantage of coming to live? As mentioned previously, easy access is possible because of Istanbul. We are living there. And then Turkish Airlines gives good opportunity with many connections. And nicely, yes, welcoming is nature of this geographic area, Istanbul. And also, more comfortable service is there. Four stars hotel service is possible for this kind of hospitals. And maybe relatively good price has some discussion. I am basically the focus on high quality medical service. High quality medical service needs experienced physicians, high level technology, teamwork, and humanism, I think. This is my educational background and long-term experience information. I am basically working on some field of the neurosurgery as a daily activities. Brain and central nervous system has very complex anatomy. This anatomy needs good understanding and very nice treatment modalities. Because of them, we need high-tech DTI, MRI, or some high-tech diagnostic facilities on the MRI. This is give us to understand patient special anatomy. In the operating theater, we are using high-tech microscope and navigation system. Navigation system gives us opportunity to take safe corridor to the lesion and to perform minimally invasive surgical process. And also high-tech technology needs for some kind of the spinal pathologies. We are using that. Routinely, I am using high-tech ultrasonographic radiological examination in the operating theater many times for every single patient, what's going on. And neuromonitorization gives us opportunity, we are using that routinely, to remove the tumor from the 1 centimeter areas, deeply located tumor, in the located eloquent areas. And also gives us opportunity to understand patients' special anatomies. Where is the motor areas of this patient? It is possible to understand easily with teamwork. And high-tech microscope gives us opportunity again to use the gliolan system to remove tumor totally. If tumor high-grade glioma, it is possible to see tumor under the microscope with this purple color. And neuroendoscopy is our daily using tools for deeply area located pathologies, or especially if tumor that is located in the skull base, we are using the nose corridor to remove them. And sometimes we are using the stereotactic methods to take a piece from the pathology on the awake patients. And sometimes if we need it, we are using the stereotactic system for put to deeply brain stimulation, especially for Parkinson's disease. Intensive care unit, our other yard, we are using routinely as a teamwork. And for example, these pictures presented the tumor. You can see easily location of the tumor, postoperatively, totally removing. And this is the pictures of the happiness, as was, I was mentioned about it. This is the Turkish man. And this man, Englishman, he was suffering from the decrease of the blood supply of the brain, and there is a life suffering risk of the patient. And after that, under this technique advance, it is possible to put bypass system from the risky areas with the new vessels, and after that, again, the pictures of the happiness. Sometimes we are using the high-tech microscope for perioperative angiography, and if we need it, I am using the awake craniotomy. The rule is, what is the patient needs? We must be understand it, and we have to perform it. This is, we say that tailored treatment modalities, we need it. If patient needs to remove the tumor, awake surgery, we perform it. And after that, after surgery, on the department, there are many issues going on. For example, this is the patient evaluation process. Email, phone calling, other online process, it is possible to take second opinion. And after the discharge, we are continue to support our patient. And I really enjoy to follow our patient with face-to-face communication many times. And I'm so happy that we have very nice neuro-oncology consul. And with our physician partners, we are discussing the situation of our patient, and we inform that about their adjunct treatment modalities. And without publication, academy is not academy. Because of them, we are publishing our experience to share. And then basically, I performed two, three times meetings, subject basic meetings, international meetings, to understand from our colleagues and share our experience. These pictures is very nice pictures. 2-3 days before, there was stormy day of the Istanbul, and then bus drivers protect the motorbike carriers from side to side, European side to Anatolian side. This is the very nice pictures of, the, I think, teamwork, humanistic teamwork, I think, or humanistic collaboration. We need it. And also, in Liv Hospital, with my team, we have same ideas and same principles. And lastly, I would like to say to you again for your next visit to Istanbul. Thank you so much.
Dear Professor, thank you for your presentation. I have a question also for you too. Brain surgery always excites me, like the making some decision and guessing what is the next, what is the future. It's also future makes me curious. So, this is combined question. What is the most efficient you think will be in the future, most efficient development in the brain surgery? What makes you, your operation, your treatment easy in the future? What is that most efficient development in your area?
Okay. I think I would like to give answer about the short time possibilities, basically. First one will be there is about nanotechnology. With nanotechnology, it is possible to deliver anti-tumor agent directly inside of the brain. There are many new ideas, and also we have same studies. I hope that 2-3 years after that time, we will, after surgery, we will put the anti-tumor agent inside of the brain after the removing of the tumor, and it will be work, I think, for long time period, disease-free life possibilities.
This technology will cure the disease or will make better to see the margin of the tumor?
There is potential, especially for some kind of the tumor type, to cure them, I think that.
Wow.
And second one, as you know, sir, know that CSF covering all of the central nervous system, it will be possible to take the, some sample from the lumbar areas from the CSF, and then early diagnosis will be possible, especially for some kind of brain disease, maybe some degenerative disease, maybe some tumors, I think that.
Okay, thank you so much. The audience, if you have questions, please ask. It is free. After this show, it will be examination fee, but now it is free. So please ask. There is one of my friends there. Yes, sure. Sorry, just a minute. We cannot hear you.
Okay. Which one?
Hello, Professor. My name is Ahmed Mohamud. I'm also one of the people who is curious about the surgical, neurological surgery. I would like to ask how deep can physicians remove the tumor inside the brain? Some of the tumors are above the scalp. It's easy to remove it. But what is the maximum depth that it can be remove it from the tumor from inside of the brain?
Yeah, sometimes it is possible to remove totally, sometimes not. Every brain has special anatomical detail, and every tumor has also, like every individual bodies. And then it is impossible to understand with MRI technology right now, but maybe it will be possible to estimate it preoperatively. But it is depend on tumor, some special situations, and tumor adhesiveness to neural tissue. I mean that. It is changeable.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
So thank you for your questions. Huh, there is one more, please.
Thank you for this expose. I have one question. For the brain aneurysm, do you prefer endovascular treatment or surgical treatment? Thank you.
Thank you. We have a study group in our hospital. Normally, if we look at the literature right now, basically, I am talking about, probably you know that, European studies, 60% of the patients endovascularly treated in the Europe, and just 40% need surgery. We have same percentage. We are discussing each other, and I say, please endovascularize this patient. And he said that, please make surgery. And we finalize our decision. And all of detail, we informed the patient. And all of together, we decided for final decision.
Thank you so much. Now we the turn is yours, Professor Emel Ceylan, nuclear medicine.
Hi, everyone.
It's a great honor to be with you all. Well, since we are talking about the groundbreaking treatment options on my side, I'll briefly touch to the radionuclide treatment options and our capabilities in nuclear medicine clinic. Before that, I'd like to introduce myself briefly. I'm a nuclear medicine specialist, and I work in that area for more than 20 years. And I'm specialized in radionuclide treatment side, especially. And I worked in many university hospitals. And for the last 4 years, I'm with the Liv family and Einstein University. In nuclear medicine, radioactivity is used to diagnose and treat the patients. The functions of many organs or systems are evaluated. Diagnosis is important. We use the different technical devices to diagnose. It's important for the treatment also, because you have to diagnose first in order to treat. And we have targeted radionuclide treatment options for different organs and systems, and the area is increasing day by day. The imaging part we were using for diagnosing and to follow the treatment response, but nowadays we also use it to select the best treatment method for the patients. One of them that we often use the diagnostic method is the PET-CT. Maybe you all know about it, but the radioactive agents that we use are increasing day by day. There are different radioactive agents that we give that give information to us, additional information about the diseases. When you treat with radiation, there are some differences when you give it from outside or internally. In radionuclide options, we give it directly to the patient. So you have chance to give more radiation to your target. What does radiation do? Well, in fact, what we try to do is to give harm to the tumor cell. We are trying to kill the tumor cells by giving damage to the DNA of the tumor. But while doing this, we don't want to give harm to the other parts of the body. Our radiopharmaceutical agents that we use for treatment are increasing day by day. The powerful treatments is not enough. You also have to achieve the low side effects. The main purpose is a powerful treatment with the low side effects. One of these targeted treatment applications is a microsphere treatment. On the left side, you see a little spheres. They are as tiny as, tinier than a strand, a hair strand. The left side is a hair strand, you see, in order to compare. When you bring these microspheres with a radioactive agent, on the left side of the screen, you see that this is the one that we use for giving to the patients. We give that agent directly to the vessels which feed the tumor cells in liver. So we have option to give a higher radiation and do not harm the other parts of the body. These little spheres goes directly to the tumor cells and starts to do its job in there by killing the tumor cells. Here, that's me before a procedure, and this is the device that we use to give the patients. And here, we are together with my colleague. I'm not alone while doing this. He's my colleague in interventional radiologist, a talented. We are working together for those patients. And this is a result. Maybe this image may not be familiar to you, but if I ask you the difference between two images on the upside and the downside, On the downside, this is the before treatments, and the colorful part is the tumor in a liver. And the upside, you see the images after treatments. There's no tumoral cells left after treatments. And another targeted treatment application that we perform is using the lutetium. This is another radioactive agent, and we give it to the patient via intravenously. And it's very comfortable for the patients. We use PSMA for prostate cancers and DOTA peptides for neuroendocrine tumors. Here, it is similar, the aspect is in fact similar. What we try to do is to reach the tumor cell, but the way sometimes differs. Here, the activity is given via IV line, but the radioactive agents go to the tumor cells and go inside, and then starts to do its job in there. I'd like to show one more image. This is the image of one of our prostate cancer patients, which was metastatic to bone, and he had lots of pain. He came to our country with a wheelchair. He had unbearable bone pain, and after on the downside, there are lots of bony metastases, and after two cycles of the treatment with lutetium PSMA, the metastatic size has gone, and the patient started to feel better, and he left the country walking. He left his wheelchair here. Well, while talking about theranostics, modern personalized therapies include the targeted therapies of tumor tissues. We have experienced a lots different developments during this little time. So our first target is to what we are trying to do is to reach an excellence in oncological care. So we are trying to use our all facilities to reach that target during that process. And thank you for listening me all.
Thank you, congratulations. But I have a question for you too. what is the difference between your Liv clinic and the other clinic that the same procedures have been done so far?
Yes, well, first of all, experience is important. We have been a reference center in Turkey, and we have lots of patients from all over the country and all over the world. But experience is not enough. Our area is very combined with the technological developments, so that's an important issue. You may have ability, but if you don't have any technical devices, you may not be able to perform them. And maybe there's one more thing that's very important, and you cannot build up easily. It's the collaborative work culture. We decide patients decide what to do to the patients together. We are not competitors. We are collaboratives and decide which treatment method is best for the patients, and we always try to be together, work together. I think this is not easy. This is not something easy to build up.
Yeah. So you have counsel.
Yes.
Talk about the patients, etc. Okay. Do you have any question, the audience? Okay. Thank you. Then the stage is yours, Professor Merdan Payda.
Thank you. Welcome. So some of you I remember from your previous visit to my hospital. So this is Liv Hospital Ulus. So this is basically more try to do explain my technical device details a little bit, and I show you some cases. So we have three devices. So one is Versa HD radiosurgery device, which can do radiosurgery and IMRT together. The other device is brachytherapy device, so this is kind of inside radiators, a little bit like nuclear medicine thing. We are sending radiation source to the patient inside. And also we have new machine, which will be the another session the next day. This is a Unity MR Linac. This is a technology that combines 1.5 Tesla MR and linear accelerator together, which is, you know, the future of medicine, you can say, or future of radiation oncology medicine. So my goal is always try to do some less side effects to the people, try to give the total radiation very small time. I know people coming from another country or another city, I try to do it very speedy way. We call it hypofractionated or stereotactic treatment. And also we know that many systemic treatments, we have to work together because, you know, chemotherapy, and other medicines, the immunotherapy are coming, and we try to work together with them. Also, we try to get as smallest field radiation as possible. This is a target-oriented and also quite fit with today's example. So both computed tomographies, ultrasound and MRI is used for treatment planning. Our main goal is always image-guided radiation, so it is very important because if there is no image, you don't know where are you treating. So we use CT, MRI, and ultrasound for image guidance. Can see combined together. So this is one of the patients treated with MR Linac. Previously, this case is not a radiation patient. This patient has paracolic metastasis. So this is near the colon, there is a metastatic focus. Originally, this patient case needed surgery, but patient don't want to go to surgery because of previous bad surgery experiences. And we did radiosurgery with MR Linac. It is impossible to see the the paracolic lesion because, you know, intestines are moving every day. But with MR Linac, you can see that day position and you can adapt your treatment planning according to that day position, so which is quite perfect. And this is, again, we need PET CT to understand how the response is, and the PET CT is clear after our treatment. And this is a very nice picture of that patient during radiotherapy. So this patient is in the treatment machine, and I am just following the patient inside, which is previously and many technology, it is not possible. We mostly do how the patient position is and then do the treatment. But during treatment, what is happening? It is again the future of medicine. And as you see, you can see the target moving. So this is a stereotactic radiosurgery. So this is another good example of removing the, you know, tumors from patient's body. Some tumors may not be movable with some systemic treatment. So you may know this diagnosis. This is nasopharyngeal adenoid cystic carcinoma. You may know that this tumor never goes back. I mean, if it's come to lungs, we know that it's too much time, it will never go. Chemotherapy not working, no specific treatment. And many metastases we have to do, we can do radiosurgery. And it is a multiple, after multiple radiosurgery, please look at 1 month later, you couldn't see anything. 6 months later, yes, you see some radiation pneumonitis, which is completely asymptomatic, but patient feels something. But 1 year later, as you see, the patient lung is there, and it's working very well, and there is no side effect. So this is almost 20 nodules is treated with radiosurgery, and patient is fully asymptomatic. I need still do some radiosurgeries, and Dr. Ferah helping me to increase the patient's lung health better, and then I will continue on many radiotherapies. So also sometimes, you know, using 3 Tesla brain MRI, you may see this from also your patients, you know, increasing number of nodules we are finding. And again, you couldn't do only one of them. You need to treat radiosurgery to each of your targets. So this machine can do multiple target radiosurgery together. Unlike gamma knife, you know, gamma knife, you don't have time to do radiosurgery for multiple lesion, but our treatment is only 20 minutes and with the radiotherapy. Again, the removing heart from the extra radiation field during Breast cancer radiotherapy is also very important. So we use some good techniques to remove, we call it breath hold radiotherapy. In this way, with this breath hold, heart is go away from chest wall and we are just sparing the heart. So this is another interesting case. Again, PET CT is very important to see the metastatic focus. This case has only one kidney because the renal cell cancer, the left kidney is removed before. The only kidney has another metastatic focus just near the kidney. And also another bone metastasis, we find it. So what we did is we did radiosurgery again for both lesions, but I have to spare the kidney because this is the only kidney. Maybe you may see from the here, this is only 7 millimeter and we give 1/3 of radiation and we spare very goodly, and after PET CT, it is a complete response. So brachytherapy is another very specialized and very important part of radiotherapy. You may know, especially gynecological cancer needs these very specific treatments, because if you don't have good brachytherapy, you couldn't treat the gynecological cancer like cervix and vaginal cancer and endometrial cancer correctly. So this is why we have huge capacity to do. So this is a liver brachytherapy, which is very, again, another important area. Sometimes the other methodologies may not work. We can use liver brachytherapy. We have specific device for gynecological brachytherapy. If sometimes we do intraoperative brachytherapy also, surgeons should remove the bulk of the tumor and then we go inside, we place our tubes and we did intraoperative brachytherapy. So this is the case, again, liver brachytherapy, 6 months later, there is no tumor. Also, prostate HDR brachytherapy, which is very important technology, you can decrease the total treatment time. So this is a one-day procedure with four hour we did treatment and patient go home. And this is, again, a good result of brachytherapy. Previously, this patient's skin is irradiated, but electron radiotherapy is not enough. The tumor is still there. Patient is very painful. We did brachytherapy, a very superficial brachytherapy, and the result is very good. We are the only Brachy Academy Educational Center. This is a non-profit organization. They are just working with us, sending some people to learn more about brachytherapy. We are the only educational center. So this is my resume. We have also an experience to work with Liv Hospital Georgia Tbilisi for 3.5 years. Once a week I go there. And this is only 1 year facts of our centers. So mostly in Unity, MR Linac, we mostly treat prostate cancer and bladder tumors. And Versa HD, we are treating image-guided intensity modulated radiation therapy for 75%. We have accepting some professional visits and we have 3 papers and 10 webinars per year. So these are my details. So it is always a team job. I couldn't do this everything without my team. I want to thank of them, and also I want to thank you so much. If any question, I will be happy to answer. Thank you.
Thank you, dear professor. I don't want to take question from the guest. Also, I don't want to ask either. Guess what? Because I am 35 years old. 2 days ago, I approved the biggest, the most expensive, the most valuable invoice in my life. That was MR Linac, so I don't want to ask any question, sorry. It's a joke, but if you have a curiosity about these technologies, MRI, brachytherapy, etc., Mr. Merdan has a groundbreaking presentation tomorrow also, so you can join that. So thank you for your patience. Also, I want to give my special respect to all of professors. For they are always make us proud with their ability, with their capacity and their know-how. So thank you for your presentations so much.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
would like to thank our general manager, Tana Özbek, and our esteemed physicians for their contributions to this important panel. I would like to remind you again that you can put your personal business card in the box waiting for you in the registration desk downstairs to participate in our giveaway, where you can win an exclusive checkup gift. We will take a short break with lunch on our Liv Hospital Expo. Lunch will be at the first floor, which is this floor. Our meeting will start again at 1:30 p.m. Bon appetit!